think, yeah, especially after stage three, as our performance was really disappointing, especially because of the first two stages. So I think after the stage three, yeah, I think we really figured out that we need to bring someone else into the team that doesn't play the game, like psychologist-wise.
At the beginning, I met Draz with the Death Row team on Aero6, and then he asked me if it was possible to start to work with the guys at Navi. So that was when we started to see what we could do with the staff and the players. I started like 1 month ago now with individual interviews. Just working about how they work, how they feel, how they're trying to improve themselves. So I came for the beginning to just see if it works with them, to present them my work and to see if it fits for everybody, and to see if everybody can find himself in this work. So yeah, 1 month ago with that. I didn't came with the idea of solving some specific problems, but when I started to talk with them and to see how the team were working, the idea was to improve in priority the relation and the mood when they are playing together, to find ways to make them in some good psychological states. By adding some intervention on different points. But the idea was to just bring them together and start to fix them some goals to reach for everybody at the same time, going in the same direction.
I think this is another voice where, whereas before we just had coaches, now we have someone that actually has experience in like psychology and all that stuff. So it's like, and right now we're, as a team, we want to improve. I genuinely believe as a team we want to improve, so there's no doubts in him, or we just do what he says, like with the breathing techniques as well, like all the stuff in the morning, like, since we got it, like the schedule for me personally has been a lot better than what I had at home, where like getting up around 9:30, eating as a team, doing some exercise, even if it's like just casual exercise together, just small things like that, it's what has made this boot camp as good as it has been. Despite the results the other day.
Ewan is our new psychologist, I guess, and he is like really helpful. It also helps that he's like similar age, I think. He's not old guy, like our manager, you know, Calf. He's very old. But yeah, feels like he's like part of the team now, and we are integrating his work with our work and vice versa. So I think it's just good to have like that other support line from someone else.
I think bringing a psychologist is, I think it's better for all of us individually, especially certain people on the team, I think, have more, like a different mindset in the game. So I think bringing in someone else who can see from outside of the game and read our minds and see how we react, I think is great.
At Mexico, I did feel nervous. So I think like with all this addition of like breathing techniques, my natural schedule, all that sort of stuff can be improved with Ewan's help. And just the way I think, for example, like my reactions, if things are going bad, if things are going good, ways to calm me down, ways to like get me more like hyped up, stuff like that can, yeah, like will help a lot.
Multiplayer games, with the Aero6 players, there is, in all the games, in fact, there is some problems about emotion management, you know, with the tilt management and things like that. There is also a lot of stress because the esports environment is a lot stressor, source of stressors. So there is the management of stress and the management of emotion that come first. And when we work with team games players, there is also all about the communication and the way to make our ideas come through and to make everything fluent in the functionment of the team. So yeah, there is those three principal problems about players.
I think it's important to like focus on the mental issues. It's not all about, you know, who can shoot people the best. I think a lot of the team's environment and winning is to do with mentality and stuff like that. So I think like the idea behind it, like I'm super with, like I'm totally up for like fixing it, but I'm not sure if it's something I would do like outside of like the team type of thing. So it's just my opinion.
I always start with the weaknesses. They have some quick implications on their results. So if that's a typical point we work on, but if the first results are not there, they have tendencies to just go in this mood of wanting to being better and to just recover from the loss, and that have some influence on the way they are playing. So there is a work that they prove that they can work on that and improve a lot on that. They have some confidence on what they can do and on the strengths. So that's kind of the point on the weakness, but on the forces, that's about the beginning of the group. There is some feelings between the players that make that when they are having fun playing at the game together, they are really efficient in the game, and for that they need to be involved in all the competitions by taking pleasure to do it and feeling they are fluent together, and that's when they are the most efficient, when they are all together and they feel that they are efficient together. So yeah.
Implementing a good schedule for us all, and more work about just outside of the game, just talking about how we feel about the team, about individuals, and just expressing our feelings to someone that is not involved in the actual game itself. I think it's good to talk to someone who has an outside perspective on the team and how we feel and how we play together.
We mostly work as a team, and I think it's good for the most part, because that kind of creates like a team bond, even if we don't like, I don't know, we don't work individually, but like as a team, we try to solve all the problems together. So that makes kind of everybody feel involved. So I think it's good.
It has audio.
Yeah, bro.
Are we?
What's your current opinions on the day today? Have you had a good night's sleep, good night's rest?
I had a great night's sleep, yeah.
Anyway, more importantly, how many kills are you dropping today?
How many kills am I dropping today?
How many kills are you dropping today?
Overall, or like per map?
Per map? Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Five?
I can't.
For Doki, I said that's the talkative one. He brings some energy to the team in the... it can be in the good and on the bad way, but it brings the energy and the dynamic in the team. I'll take them from one to the others, but for Nice, that's kind of more the hard worker in the team, in my point of view, because in the way he wants to prove that he's good in this game, because he has a lot of qualities, but he wants to show to the others that he can manage the pressure and the performance in any way. For secretly, I say that the Sage one of the team, because he has a lot of experience and he came with this Zen attitude, you know, pacing up when the team became too fast on feel too much emotions at the same time. For Byron, that's the, how do you say that? The man in the shadow, I would say. He took a lot of information by being not that much talkative. At the opposite, we could say with Doki, he has this energy that makes him more impactant when he talks and when he adds some information on the game and on his teammates. So that makes a lot from him. And for the last one, Saves, I would say that he brings some strict performance or direction to the team that helps to put some square on the way they are working together.
Yeah, I mean, the exercises aren't like I'm about to feel like I'm going to pass out after, but I mean, I think it's fun because the fact that we're doing it together and you get to see other people's reaction to the exercises and all that sort of stuff, so I think that's the best part about it.
Our psychologist is mostly focused on our behavior, our mood, and our attitude, I would say. And I think he's really helpful in that for the past bootcamp and well before that. Because the mood changed, well, if you are losing, the mood is obviously pretty bad most of the time. But I think we solved that issue and the mood is getting slowly and slowly better. So I think having a psychologist is really useful.
They love playing their game, so that's a point I found in each of them. They're really open mind about what we can do and what they want to improve. They're really interested in what we are doing, and that brings some really positive energy in the improvement of what they are doing and what we are doing together. So yeah, that's really, really enjoyable to work with them about that.
Right now, well, I think we are going in a good direction with, like I said before, fixing the mood in general. Because obviously every single one of us is a good player and we know how to play the game. We just have to focus on not losing the passion to play the game.